welcome my colleagues from the media. We are hosting for the first time the annual press conference of Bosch in a virtual way, so I would like to welcome all of you virtually. While you are watching this, I am hopeful that all of you are safe at your respective locations. Stay safe, that's important. The breakup for the day is we will have a presentation now. The presentation will be from Mr. Soumitra Bhattacharya, Managing Director of Bosch Limited and President of Bosch Group in India. This will go on for about 20 minutes and then we'll go into the Q&A session. While we go into the Q&A session, a detailed note was already provided to you on this. There is a Q&A box right next to the visual screen which you see. The box takes only 500 characters. So please keep your questions crisp. Also, please remember to type your name and your publication or media house that you represent. This is important because at Bosch we value privacy a lot and we will not come to know otherwise who are you going to, who are you and who are you asking the question to. In the question panel, we will also have Mr. Jan Oliver Rohl, Joint Managing Director of Bosch Limited and Chief Technology Officer. So we can have questions addressed to both of them. So without taking any further time now, I would like to hand it over to Mr. Bhattacharya to start with the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Amit, and to colleagues, a very warm afternoon. And thank you for joining in. While many of us realize that this is not a face-to-face contact, but yet this virtual contact that we are having is something that we have to live in the new normal. So, thank you very, very much. I'd like to share with you in what context we are going to talk today and what I'd like to share with you. It's not only about the year gone by, which is the fiscal year 1920, but it's also the fiscal year 2021 and the turbulent times that we are going through, and which we call it living in the new normal. So let's watch a video here. Can we have the AV, please?
2019-20 has not been like any other year for the Indian automotive industry. After a steady growth for nearly a decade, the automotive sector in India has begun to witness a severe slowdown. This year, the industry has registered a decline across all four segments. Negative market sentiments coupled with liquidity crisis, continuing with high impact on short-term and long-term lending, has posed a major setback for the industry. While we have a stable government that was re-elected, the signs of recovery are clearly not visible in the near future. With almost 80% of our turnover from the mobility sector, at Bosch, we strongly believe that the Indian mobility sector is undergoing a paradigm shift. The changes are not cyclical, but structural in terms of the changing dynamics of the powertrain. The year 2020 started with an unprecedented crisis the world was not prepared for. COVID-19 pandemic, commonly known as coronavirus, managed to halt the world economy. COVID-19 pandemic has not only posed a serious threat to human condition, it has also brought nations to a standstill. With public life coming to a grinding halt, the vehicle sales have plummeted. As the pandemic continues, social distancing will have an impact on mobility behavior and preferences, ushering in a new normal that will potentially change the way we see things. However, at Bosch Limited, we have embraced these challenges. While the impact is clearly visible in the short term, our long-term vision of reshaping the future of mobility continues with absolute conviction for a better tomorrow. Let's have a look at the year that was.
Thank you, colleagues. You got a glimpse of the year that was, and I will share not only what happened in 2019-20, but I'll also share with you our way forward for 2021 and beyond. So this is the agenda which I want to share with you on what's happening in the Bosch global world, what's happening in Bosch India. As you know, Bosch in India has 18 plants, has 15 legal entities, and has one of the highest engineers in the world after, you know, for R&D after Germany. And we will talk, of course, in details today about Bosch Limited, the flagship company, and which we have here for the last 65, 66 years. The year 2019, what's happening in 20, what our financial results look like, and very importantly, our way forward. And finally, I'll summarize what I've spoken in the key messages. Next slide, please. This gives you a view of the Bosch global world, and it talks about the facts and the figures. And these are the numbers which have already been released. So 2019 for Bosch Global was also a year full of challenges, and especially in the mobility area globally. In spite of a challenging year, Bosch globally was able to keep the turnover of sales revenue, which is 77.7 billion, and with an EBIT of 2.9 billion euros. So the turnover is more or less similar to the calendar year 2018 levels. What is interesting is, though there was a pressure on the EBIT, Bosch still continued to invest 6.1 billion euros on research and development. As you know, for decades, Bosch has been investing anywhere between the region of 8 to 10% of its turnover on research and development, because innovation and change is a part of the DNA of Bosch worldwide. Here you can see 72,600 researchers and engineers doing application and research, as also Bosch's presence in 60 countries with 440 subsidiaries. Next slide, please. Now, coming to Bosch in India. Now, Bosch globally, you must understand, has four business verticals. Those verticals are mobility solutions, energy and building technology, consumer goods, and industrial technology. All these verticals are represented in India in the 15 group companies that we have, with Bosch Limited as the flagship company of the Bosch Group in India, which in 2019-20 had a turnover of approximately 10,000 crores, to be precise, 9,800 crores. Now, Bosch India has been doing Make in India for more than 65 years, and we have been playing a very important part in the development of this country and the transformation the last many decades. You'll be happy to know that Bosch in India will turn 100 years in 2022, that means in just 2 years, and we are one of the oldest arms of Bosch globally. We have been doing manufacturing in India, Make in India, for a long time, since 1953. We currently have 16 manufacturing entities. They are located in multiple states all over India, but also in the states of Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and Rajasthan. Our fuel injection equipment, which goes into the ICE or internal combustion engine, has played an integral role since the time of the Green Revolution, as also played a very strong role in India's railway network. Bosch in India employs more than 31,500 associates and is the home, as I mentioned, to 18,000 engineers across 7 locations, representing the largest R&D facility and workforce outside Germany. Next slide, please. 2019 has been a year of challenges. What started with an NBFC crisis and went into a deep liquidity crunch in the year 1920 also led to a strong and huge market slowdown. And this slowdown has not been seen since 2008 and 9. In the market, we saw a lot of structural changes. Take the example in automotive, where axle norms were changed, and overnight there was a 20% capacity available in the heavy commercial vehicles or the light commercial vehicles. Climate change has been also a very important topic, and you must remember India holds the dubious distinction of having 15 of the top 20 most polluted cities in terms of particulate matter lie in India. Therefore, it's both a challenge, but I would also say in a positive way, an opportunity for us to change this. Next slide. The vehicle production in the fiscal year 1920 saw an unprecedented drop of 17%. While we had a majority government coming in, the slowdown in the economy that took place and the structural changes that took place had an unprecedented crisis during the year 2019-20. And as I mentioned, just the HCV had a huge drop of minus 47%, LCV minus 22%. Cars and utility vehicles of 15% minus, three-wheelers 11% minus, and tractors minus 15%. Every element for the first time after many years, we've seen a huge drop. Next slide, please. 2020 is an unprecedented crisis in the whole world, not just in India. And just while we were about to finish the financial crisis, India had to go through the biggest and deepest lockdown starting from 24th midnight of March, where the Prime Minister announced, and that was lockdown 1, which has now carried on to lockdown 4.0. Automotive industry, like many industries, came to a grinding stop halt, and we from Bosch proactively shut down our plants from 23rd of March. 6 of our plants were shut down, and for 6 weeks we have had no resumption. We have recently started. 80% of our white collars were doing work from home, a new normal. And on 5th of May, we started our resumptions, but on a very low scale of 10 to 20%. And with very strict adherence to lessons learned, and most importantly, safety and hygiene for our colleagues and also the Bosch ecosystem. Next slide, please. The contributions from Bosch Limited have always been sustainable, and we have always looked at an India first agenda, be it our technologies, be it our values, or more importantly, be it our care for society. Bosch India, including Bosch Limited, have given a pledge to spend 50 crores for the COVID situation that we have, of which 5 crores already given to the Prime Minister care. We are about to set up an automated mask line with high quality of 1,20,000 masks per day. And these masks will be used for our own facilities and Boschlers and the Bosch ecosystem, but also we will give a big chunk of it for society, including for the hospitals. Our technology colleagues are working on repairing 125 ventilators, helping in designing to do breathing assists, as also we have supplied huge amount of sanitizers and masks in the state of Karnataka. And finally, we have been feeding and taking care a lot of migrant workers, including from our canteens, as well as working with partners like Akshay Patra or Art of Living. Next slide, please. The performance by Bosch under very difficult circumstances in 2019-20 has been rather creditable. Our margin from operations is 11.2%, where we've seen a decline in the turnover by nearly 19%. The automotive market itself went down by more than 17%, and our sales came down to about 9,800 crores. Next slide, please. So here you see the detailed results, and I would just like to say the numbers that need to be concentrated are that if you look at April-March 2020, our net sales, total income from operations of 9,810 crores against the previous year of 12,000 crores, and also that tells you that there's a downturn of 18%. Now we must understand that mobility business sector had a reduction of approximately 20%, and the powertrain business itself declined by 24%, whereas our automotive aftermarket declined also by 11% due to tight liquidity in the market. Our beyond mobility business sector registered a reduction of 12% and domestic sales reduced by 21% with export decline of around 4%. Next slide. This gives you the details and I will just tell the highlights. Material cost, we have had improvement from 55% earlier to 53%. Employee cost has reduced by 6%. Our other expenses, while it increased marginally, we have ensured that profit before tax and before exceptional items is at 16.6%. This as compared to the previous year of 19%. Now, this is very good as a performance under very difficult circumstances. We have prudently provided for provisions of more than 7,000 million INR, that means 710 crores for redeployment, restructuring and retraining. Also for inventory for BS4 where required. And very importantly, our profit before tax after exceptional items stood at 9% because of this huge amount that we have prudently provided for. Profit after tax before exceptional items on a comparable basis to last year is 13% and previous year was 13.2. So again, you can see both PBT as well as PAT before exceptional at comparable basis. Next slide, please. We had the board meeting today and the directors of the company and the board has approved a payout of 105 rupees per share. And this is a very good payout of 50% under trying circumstances. This gives a very clear message that while we see a strong downturn now for the short term, we as a company will bounce back in the midterm and are confident about the long term. Next slide, please. Our resumption from operation hinges on ensuring reassurance to our associates and coordination to achieve a demand-supply balance, because these are the two most important things. Most important is, as we said, associates. Second important is to take care of the supply chain. Now, we are coordinating with authorities, customers, suppliers to ensure a slow but a smooth ramp up. We know that industrial recovery will be slow and we are trying to ensure that supply chain bottlenecks are removed from the way. And also, we are aware there are going to be challenges on migrant labor and labor for our suppliers. Next slide. The BS6 changeover is perhaps the most important thing that has happened in the automotive industry. And as my colleague, Mr. Jan Rohl, who will join me later, would talk about, is this is the fastest change from BS4 to BS6 anywhere in the world. So Bosch India is proud to announce that we have had 79 OEM projects deliveries and we have had the largest share, and in the automotive auto expo, we already announced that a lifetime acquisition of nearly 24,000 crores. Bosch believes very strongly in giving technologies of the future, and this is included in our BS6 examples. And also, you'll be happy to know this has been delivered completely out of India. Next slide. Our electric powertrain solutions, Bosch invests worldwide more than 400 million euro every year. More than 8 lakh vehicles are running with Bosch solutions in electromobility. You'll be happy to know that the new Bajaj Chetak electric scooter, both the dealership, the product and the diagnostic solutions come all from Bosch. We have put up a project house electrification already 2 years ago, and like the Chetak, we will progressively announce our partnership with various OEMs as also the various areas that we will get into in electrification. We strongly believe that electrification in India will start with two-wheeler, three-wheeler and will coexist with ICE, which will still remain dominant up to 2030 with 80% of total vehicles would be ICE and up to 20% would be electrification. We are creating a technology agnostic approach all the time, and Bosch will continue on this road for a long time. Next slide. Our mobility services and connected solutions are both personalized, they are innovative, intelligent, and they are cloud-based services. We are using the vehicle as a node or a sensor on the Internet of Things, and combined with the use of field data and data analytics, this will help us to optimize traffic in a variety of ways. Some examples are the Bajaj Chetak, the Daimler eCall, and our connected solutions have a 3D display, which in the future, these digital displays will play a very important role of an interaction between both the drivers and their vehicles. Next slide, please. Bosch has always believed in climate action. Bosch's global announcement on carbon neutrality for the whole Bosch group by 2020, and Bosch India also will pursue and will be carbon neutral by ensuring of tapping local availability, natural resources of energy. Just to give you an example, Nasik location, which began photovoltaic systems in 2015, it has today 50,000 solar panels in the rooftops, and 20% of the entire plant's usage comes from solar. The facility has helped in reducing carbon emission by 23,000 tons and has saved over 25,000 megawatt hours of energy since 2015. This is equivalent to some 25,000 Indian household homes. The same with Biddi, where we cover 30% of our plant's requirement from photovoltaic system that we have installed. Next slide, please. Bosch continues to deliver technology agnostic solutions. And going back to the start of my presentation, where I have mentioned that Bosch played a very important role in India's green revolution, as also the railway network through our technology, we continue to invest locally, and currently we have the unique leverage of the global technology and a very wide footprint of manufacturing in India, and with the largest software setup of services outside Germany. So the Bosch invention of sensor, software, and services philosophy, which create technology agnostic solutions, will partner India in its journey of transformation for us to be able to give solutions to our customers. In summary, I would like to say that though financial year 2020, that is 19-20, was a very major setback in the auto industry, where incomes declined by around 18.6% against a drop in the automotive market of 17%, still we see that the pandemic will create an even bigger challenge in the year 2021. We are focusing to be continued to fit for the market by having restructuring programs, which we started well before COVID. We will, in my view, need multiple years in India for the auto industry to come back to the peaks of 2018. And unless there are special interventions by the government of India on direct stimulus for the auto industry, this could stretch for a long time. However, in Bosch, we are confident that we will bounce back by 22-23, 23-24 to our original levels and climb further, which is well ahead of the market, because we are not only catering to our core, but also to adjacencies. And you will get to hear from us in the near future about the new business approaches and projects that we will announce in the year 2021 as we move forward, both in mobility solutions, also in electrification, and be a continued leader on tech agnostic solution. Last slide. This is a picture of the Bosch Adugudi campus. And this is not a 3D image. This is something that you will get to see while we are constructing it now. You will see the new smart Bosch India campus, 75 acres in the heart of Bengaluru, which will be completed by 2022. This is the new face of Bosch in India with its people. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Mr. Bhattacharya, for the presentation. I will request the colleague to please remove the dais. Now we'll start. Don't click the send button. We'll be not receiving your questions over here. So you can ask your questions now and we can start with the question answer session. I will take up the questions sequentially as they appear on my screen. So I request the colleagues from the media to start and get into the question answer sessions, please. There will be a 40-second delay. Do we have the questions coming up? So we have the first question that has already come on our screen. The question comes from Anusuya Basu from the Telegraph. And the question is, when will the auto industry turn around post-COVID? Anusuya, for the next set of questions and for the other colleagues on the media, I request whom you would like to address this question as well, to Mr. Roll or Mr. Bhattacharya. You can type in a B or a R for quick typing experience. Yeah. But for this, I would like to direct it to Mr. Bhattacharya. Over to you, Mr. Bhattacharya.
Thank you. So this is a million-dollar question and a very good question and a little bit of crystal gazing, but I'll try to give you a directional answer. You must remember that when we had the slowdown in 2019-2020 pre-COVID, already compared to the peak of 2018, India had lost approximately 3.5 to 4 years. That means it would take India 2022 to get back to 2018 levels. Now, post-COVID, you can add another 1.5 to 2 years to it. Of course, this will get changed subject to stimulus, subject to sentiment, and subject to spending power, and of course, GDP growth. So these are the subject twos. We in Bosch, of course, want to come back much earlier. So you can, in summary, take a safe bet anywhere between 4 to 6 years, and either it will take a little earlier or slower, depending on the topics that I mentioned to you.
Thank you. The next question we have is from T. Murali from Motoring Trends. The pandemic has created even bigger challenge in 2021. How are you preparing as Bosch to overcome these challenges? Over to you, Mr. Bhattacharya, for this.
So, Murali, the pandemic has created challenges already in 2020, which means 2020/21, you're right. It's going to be there for quite some time, and that's why we said living in the new normal. So we anticipate that there could be a reduction of 30% in the automotive market for the year 2020/21 overall. Now, what are the challenges and what are we trying to do? The first challenge is safety and hygiene. Now, Bosch is being very particular on a very slow and safe startup to create an environment where our colleagues can come. So right now, as I speak, between 10 and 20% of our colleagues have come into all our units, including our offices, not more. Second, we are trying to ensure that the supply chain works. 25% of India's economy right now is closed on either containment zones or hotspots due to COVID, and supply chains are clearly disrupted. And third, it's very important to produce what the supply chain needs and not have over high inventory. Last point, and which is very important for all India, but in Bosch we have taken tremendous focus and we are luckily, you know, we don't have to borrow, is that liquidity and cash is king. So we have tremendous focus on cash flow, free cash flow. We are looking at receivables, collections, inventory, capital expenditure. We are cutting back on all what is not necessary, and very important also on payables, being a value-based company.
Thank you. The next question we have is from PTI, Mr. Rajkumar. He has two questions typed in. The first one is company facing labor availability issues post lockdown, and how are we dealing with it and how it can impact the production? While what is the plan for recovery and when the company will think that the demand will come back? So I'll pose this question to both of you, starting with Mr. Roll.
I would request my colleague to take it forward and then I'll add if anything at all.
Yeah, it's very valid and good questions. I would take the first one first with regards to labor availability. We have a new norm, as Sumitra Bhattacharya was mentioning, and that is translating also into work from home. So all our white collar people, all our engineers, software engineers are working from home, and only in exceptional cases they come to work already now. All our operations have resumed, so be it in warehouses, be it in the plants. And also here we cannot observe any labor shortcomings. Also linked to the fact that for the moment we can only operate in a shift from maximum 7 to 7 due to the curfew that is hereafter. The second question was related to the when is the demand coming back? And I think partly this was already answered. I would just like to add, we have currently a situation where we have two things happening at a time. We have a supply crisis and a demand crisis, and both needs to be fixed. And fixed means also the things that were already there in the market and disturbing, if you will, the customer sentiments, they are still there and they need to be addressed, be it liquidity, be it, let's say, new technologies that have to find their way in the market. All this needs to be addressed.
So nothing more to add, I think. Very comprehensive reply.
Thank you. The next question we have is for Mr. Bhattacharya, and this comes from Suman from BT. Is Bosch planning to lay off or reduce salaries? Also, do you see or foresee full resumption of your factories?
Look, full resumption of factories will require two important things. First, safety is a must, and therefore resumption will happen, but it will take some time. And second, you resume and go fully back to work based on what your customer needs. Right now, the customer call-offs are relatively low because they are also just starting up very slowly. And finally, you must remember the auto industry is dependent on tier 1, tier 2, tier 3. And if one of them fails, even with one small part, everything comes to a grinding halt. So the whole supply chain is very important. On the matter regarding how are we handling our employees? I can only say one thing. Bosch has been always a very value-based and a very caring company towards all its employees. And even before COVID, the small amount of EVRs that we did were always EVRs. So we have not cut jobs or sacked jobs. We have either redefined jobs, we have looked at our structures, and we have done the few with caring. And this philosophy of Bosch will continue, on one hand, to care for its employees, on the other hand, to ensure that the company is continuing to face the market realities and restructures itself.
Thank you. The next question we have is from Rajiv Ghosh from Economic Times Prime to you, Mr. Bhattacharya. What is the market share of Bosch Limited in BS6 diesel powertrains for commercial vehicles, both light and heavy segments?
So Rajiv, you are well aware we both don't give guidance nor do we give market shares. While remaining, while having major respect for our competitors and having a pretty good market share in multiple areas including diesel, our objective has been, and I will ask my colleague to say a couple of words, to be a front runner as in the earlier days and in the past to the future. And BS6 is a very good example, and my colleague Jan Oliver Roll, who's also the CTO of the company, can say a few words because he runs this business himself.
Thank you for the question. Let me put it that way. Our customers, they had confidence in us before BS6 was announced, with BS4, with BS4, with BS3, and that confidence was repeatedly there also for BS6. We have to thank the customers for this. It was a very, very challenging time for all of us. Multiple drivetrains to be addressed, be it passenger car, but you specifically were asking light duty, mid duty, and heavy commercial vehicle. And I think the teams on both sides, so all our customers together with us, we did a great job here. That job was supported by more than 1,400 engineers from Bosch globally, I must say. So of course we had a big team here in the flagship company, which is Bosch Limited, but we joined intensely hands with our engineering software company, which is from the pure number, far bigger with engineers than we are in Bosch Limited. And we were also relying on the international development network that we were using to a large extent. So unremarkably, if you will, because COVID was kind of overshadowing that situation, BS6 has found successfully the way in the market.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Rohl. The next question we have is from Jim. So what I feel, Mr. Bhattacharya, is the Maruti Baleno electric prototype, which we had created in 2018, is still very fresh in the minds of the media, and they just did this time at the Auto Expo as well. So it's our electrification portfolio that Jim from Car India is more interested in, is talking about. What do we have in the electric portfolio, and is it based on the e-axle platform? So the electrification portfolio.
So I think both of us will answer this question. I want to say, first of all, that car which we had shown as a prototype in the previous Auto Expo showed the prowess of Bosch worldwide, but also India, that we have a full menu card for electrification in Bosch worldwide across all the concepts of from an e-bike right up to a heavy commercial vehicle, including fuel cells. Now, in the e-axle, which has been very common and seen worldwide, we had shown that as an example. In India, of course, the power range requirement is lower. It's anywhere for four-wheelers, anywhere between 20 and 50, 60 kilowatt hour mainly. I'm talking of the compact vehicle. And we have shown that we have the prowess to do things in two-wheeler, three-wheeler, four-wheeler. And the two-wheeler launch that we did, and before I had also mentioned to you the three-wheeler near SOP stage that we have worked with OEMs, shows where we are. On the e-axle part, maybe you can add a couple of sentences.
Yeah, thanks, Jim. If you remember that car, which was a concept car 2 years back, it must have left quite an impression on you. And we were also quite impressed of that vehicle because it was completely done here by the engineering team in India, and all that in parallel of the launches of BS6 powertrain solutions for diesel, gasoline, across all the on-highway platforms that you can imagine. It's a concept car, and we were using components out of the shelf for, let's say, getting first-hand experience, not only for the engineers, but also for our customers. As we speak today, there is a still very nascent market for electric vehicles in India, and our perspective is that hybrid vehicles, they will find their way far quicker in the market. And also here we are having not only the first projects, but we are already supplying the first elements to some of the customers who are running here also for BS6 with hybrid vehicles in the Indian market.
Thank you. The next question we have is for Mr. Bhattacharya, and this question comes from Sumantra from Autocar. Will Bosch continue the work from home approach even after the lockdown restrictions are removed? If yes, what percentage of workforce would operate from offices? A part of it you have already answered, but just to reiterate on this point.
So the work from home all over the world, but also for India, has been predominantly enforced by COVID. But I think it's given a very good perception to everyone, including in Bosch in India. Today, as we have opened operations, not more than 15 to 20% of our colleagues are working in the office. That means 80% are still working from home. As we progressively go over the weeks and months, more and more colleagues will come, but we will continue on work from home as a policy. Percentage, I can't tell you. We will be defining it differently for, Bosch Limited is predominantly an engineering company. We have a very big software company that will be done in a different way. But yet from engineering companies, we will have definitely certain amount of work from home. Percentage right now, we are yet to define.
Okay. The next question we have here is from Economic Times. The question comes from Neha. Is company facing shortage of workers due to the reverse migration and also again on the salary cuts and layoffs? So we could talk on the reverse migration.
Yeah, on the reverse migration, we have not had a major impact in Bosch because, you know, we don't employ migrant laborers and we employ very few contract laborers and with no contract workmen in the shop floor. And this has been a Bosch philosophy for decades. So keeping that in mind, most of our blue collar associates, if I may say so, or some trainees, they are in the vicinity of the cities where they are. So we don't see that as the most important challenge. What we do see a challenge is our supply chain, the couple of tiers below us, for them to have a problem because many of them employ migrant labor and there's been a huge exodus of migrant labor. I'd already talked to you about the other 2 points that you've mentioned.
Yeah, the next question we have on screen is from Giriprakash from Hindu. At what levels in terms of percentage will the 16 all factories work in the next 6 months?
Giriprakash, it's a difficult question to answer specifically. I would say it will be a graded lift up both for the lockdown and a graded lift up on ramp up for production for industry, including auto industry and therefore Bosch India. And again, I repeat, our first focus will be safe ramp up. Our second focus will be to meet our customers' requirements through inventory and production, but not to overproduce and keep inventory lying because that doesn't help. So we will do it based on customer and market need.
Okay. The next one we have is from Abhilasha Singh from Financial Express. This is on, again, electrification portfolio. While we mentioned about electrification and we say that we already have a high tech, is India looking at a spike in EV adoption post-COVID? And will EV drive substantial chunk of supply chain globally? So both of you.
I'll give a quick answer before handing over to my colleague. We must first demystify this matter about EV, and I'll try to do it in exactly 1 minute. Our global CEO spoke in the Global Mobility Summit and also shared with Mr. Modi, and I fully support what he said. In India, electrification will first come with two-wheeler and three-wheeler. And it will be for the delivery systems and for the fleet and taxis and things like that, and then within two-wheeler, three-wheeler, mainly two-wheeler, it will come for personal mobility. The TCO, which is the most important part, total cost of ownership, will work out for electrification, starting with two-wheeler, three-wheeler. Pass cars will follow later, but only fleet. And pass cars individual is still quite some way away from meeting TCO requirements. Over to you, Jan.
Yeah, to add now, difficult. I see it as follows. I don't expect a spike to come directly to that question because we have always to ask ourselves, where does electric vehicle play a meaningful role in the future and why having an electric vehicle? And that's for two reasons predominantly. The first one is where you ride your car, your two-wheeler, your bus. Locally, there is low to no emission coming out of the exhaust because there is no exhaust. And secondly, it is contributing positively to the CO2 balance sheet, provided it's coming out of renewable energies. So the last one I would address first. Here I would like to see India to follow a strong path on CO2 targets in the future, so which has been laid out with the CAFE draft, for example, and that to be continued with the clarity on the roadmap ahead for the years to come. Related to the emissions, so the first part of the motivator, I think in principle there are good solutions now available specifically for the passenger car side with BS6 and technologies, let's say, provided from the OEM with a lot of effort in very short time with partners like, for example, us to the Indian market. And we should give these technologies also a chance to really prove what they promised.
Thank you, Mr. Rohl. Just reminding colleagues from the media, we have lots of questions which have come in. So first, thank you for that. We have a hard stop exactly at 3:15. So we will need to stop at 3:15. We'll try to answer as many questions as possible till that time. So the next question comes from Money Control. It comes from Swaraj. The question is, what is the capex for FY21 and has it been revised? And if yes, how much? Over to you, Mr. Bhattacharya.
So I'll keep it short and crisp with your hint. We have reduced capex substantially for non-essential need. We have kept capex, for example, for our Adugudi campus, because that's something that we want to complete as a smart campus. We have kept capex for our future projects, whether be it in mobility solutions, whether in electrification or other areas, and yet we have reduced substantially. To give you a ballpark idea, Bosch Limited has capex anywhere in the last 5 years, anywhere between 350 crores to 500 crores. And we are approximately keeping 40% reduction to 50% reduction on this.
Thank you. Could we have the next question, please? Thank you. The next question we have is from Rajesh from Motor India. How are you dealing with the added cost of health and safety measures versus the lower revenues, given the significant change on the shop floors? Please also elaborate on the robotics and the digitalization platforms for operational efficiency. And also if we could look at exports and import substitutes. So lots of questions, three of them. Rajesh, you have utilized all your 500 characters, I believe. So I will give this to both of you. Yeah. Over to you first, Mr. Bhattacharya, for the first part of the...
So I'll just take 30 seconds and hand over to my colleague. Rajesh, whether there are lower revenues or not, health and safety still comes first. We as Bosch, as a value-based company, will not dilute that. And this is, I can tell you, Bosch India and Bosch Limited is perhaps one of the benchmarks in the industry in the way we handle health, safety, care and concern. Over to you on robotics.
Okay.
Yeah, could we have the question again on screen? Yeah, please. Thank you.
Yeah, digitization plays a major role, whether it's in supply chain, whether it's in day-to-day work, whether it's in engineering itself. Just to give one example out of something that is close to my heart, which is the engineering part for the powertrain. Here we are experimenting with digitization and with artificial intelligence. So we want to use the data that we gathered along with BS6 calibration work for all the types of vehicles to use it to become quicker to market solutions whenever there is a roadmap for new emissions ahead of us. And we hope, of course, that India is continuing its firm path. Digitization plays, of course, also a matter in operations. Now, if you would have the chance to visit one of our plants, for example, in Bidati, we could showcase a lot of examples here. This is a firm part of our manufacturing strategy, by the way, not only for the flagship company Bosch Limited, but for all the plants, all the 18 plants here in India.
So I'll add one sentence, Amit, for Rajesh. There are three artificial centers, artificial intelligence centers in the world for Bosch. One of them is India. That tells you something.
Thank you. The next question we have is from Shruti from ET Auto. The question is, since 80% of our revenues are dependent on mobility, what are the de-risking measures we are planning to adopt post the COVID era? Over to you.
So Shruti, I mentioned to you, while we are very strong in mobility, we are wanting to further gain market share on our non-mobility area. And in mobility, we want to grow faster than the market. How? In our core, we are very strong. We want to retain that. You heard about BS6. In our adjacencies, where we have many examples, we want to further higher the bar. And in new areas of business, whether if you look at, you know, the whole aspect of mobility, where you look at software, sensors and services, where you look at mobility through a digital platform, where we already have our project house, these areas, where you look at the battery, where you look at energy, these areas have a lot of scope, and Bosch India and Bosch Limited will play in these areas. So we will make announcements as we go by on the further areas we are widening. Bottom line, we want to grow better than the market in the years to come.
The next question we have is from Abhishek. This is the question of the season, which all of us and all the CEOs and the C-suite has been answering. The 20 lakh crore package announced by the government, and how will it positively impact the auto sector? Over to you.
So Abhishek, I think on one hand, the entire country has been very positive and euphoric about the announcement of the package. While the package has addressed many sectors of society, including the migrant labor, the MSMEs, agriculture, and then these are very, very strong points of the package, it has not yet impacted with direct stimulus for the industry nor for the auto industry. Let me give you two examples. There was a request from the auto industry, whether from SIAM, ACMA, CII, that could we look into the possibility of GST reduction for X number of months reduction from 28 to 18. There was also a request, which is a long request to the government of India, on scrappage policy and the introduction of that. And I, on behalf of the auto industry, also look forward that the government of India will be able to give in the near future direct stimulus package that's required by industry, specifically to the auto industry, and which can help to turn around this industry, which gives massive employment directly and indirectly.
Thank you. The next question we have is from Abhijit Singh from Auto Car Review. This one I'll direct to you, Mr. Rohl. Can PHEV form a more viable bridge towards transition to EVs in passenger car markets? Does Bosch have a solution for affordable mass market adoption of PHEVs in India?
I would say simply yes, we have, and this is starting with a 48 volt solution, be it so-called P0, P3, or also a P4 solution, which is, let's say, explaining where exactly you would like to provide the power before, in or after the transmission gearbox. So yes, we have that, and by the way, we have not only components, but we offer a complete system solution, which is existing of the power pack, which is combining the same with a 48 volt battery, a DC-DC converter, and finally also a vehicle control unit in the sense if required.
Thank you. We have only last 5 minutes left, colleagues, so maybe one or two questions max is what we would be able to answer. So the first question that we see here is from Ghanshyam Tiwari from AutoTrack. This question is to you, Mr. Bhattacharya. Is Bosch anticipating an early recovery through online sales to end customer as compared to physical sales? Also, Bosch Car Care Service has door-to-door service option due to COVID.
So, Ghanshyam, this is a very intelligent and nice question. My answer would be both. The world will not go totally digital, and the world will not be only physical. And this applies also, therefore, to the auto industry. So you have to take a physical delivery of the vehicle. You can't take an online virtual delivery. Yeah, but you can book it online. So the same thing is what we are trying to do in Bosch. A lot of our processes are becoming more and more digital, including the Bosch Car Service, on ability to take it from your doorstep and do it. But naturally, the physical activity will continue, both from the customer as well as the supplier.
Okay. On the car service, the same thing, I would assume.
It's the same thing for the Bosch Car Service. I mentioned that same.
Yeah. Thank you. Can we have the next question, please? Yeah, the next question we have is from Suvrat from EVO India. With imports affected, how much more boost does Bosch look at localization of components and Make in India initiative? Both of you. This one. Good. Over to you, Mr. Rohl, first.
Look, we always look at Make in India. We look in the present, and of course we look in the future as well. And our market position is enabling us as well, let's say, to not only look but also to firmly plan with that. So of course we have plans for further localization of components also related to the powertrain.
Okay. Could we have the next one, please?
The last one?
Yes. The last one here we have is from Yaruk Khan from Congenus Information Services. How have Bosch supply chain systems been affected due to COVID-19? What are the losses the company has sustained, and what supply chains likely to normalize? So this is something which we have as a last.
So Yaruk, I'll be very honest with you that, you know, April has been a wipeout for whole industry, auto industry, and Bosch is not an exception. So if you don't have any economic activity of production sale, so April has been that. The month of May and June will be, May will be a slow startup, which I've already mentioned. And June, I estimate practically the whole auto industry will not be doing activity of more than 20-25% at the best. And at the lowest, it could be even 15%. So we will follow the auto industry in a similar manner. But as I mentioned again, we will strengthen our adjacencies and we will get into new areas, including in the digital space. And in 2021, we will keep you informed about the projects we are doing once they get into SOP.
Okay. So we have last 22 minutes left. I think we could just go into the closing comments from both of you before we end the conference for the day. Over to you, Mr. Roll, to start with.
Of course, let's say most of the questions, they are running around what is happening in times of course COVID crisis, because we are in the middle of it, yeah? And we don't know exactly when this has been ending. I endorse very much what the government of India has decided so far with lockdown, and now this staggered exit out of the lockdown, and giving re-impulses to the industry and to the economy, and endorsing that. I think this is what we have to look at, that the industry and the economy is picking up in these difficult times.
So I would like to just tell my colleagues a few sentences about our company. Our parent has weathered the test of time for the last 135 years and reinvented itself. And we ourselves in India have reinvented ourselves for the last 98 years and reinvented in manufacturing for the last 67 years. So I strongly believe with the technology we have, the support from our parent, our global reach, our local depth of manufacturing, technology, intelligence on hardware, software, artificial intelligence, sensors, we will give solutions to the industry, and we will always innovate and give affordable solutions. And with that, while 2020-21 will be a very, very difficult and challenging year for everyone, including Bosch India, I strongly believe India, in the midterm, we will bounce back, and in the long term, for Bosch India as well as for India, it is going to be one of the places to come to. So I'm very confident in a quiet way for the long term, and for the medium term, I'm very clear that we will work to ensure that we are better than the market, while in the short run, we are going to go through the biggest challenges we've ever faced in this century and in the last 100 years. Thank you.
So first, thank you to the colleagues from the media for your overwhelming participation. We had immense amount of questions coming in. All the questions that we couldn't answer, we have recorded with us, and we will get back to you with the answers. Thank you for joining in once again. Stay safe. It's important at these times, and we'll stay connected with you. With this, we end the Bosch Limited's press conference for the day. Thank you, and stay safe once again. Thank you, Mr. Bhattacharya. Thank you, Mr. Roll, for joining us today.
On behalf also, thank you to all the media, Amit, from both our sides, for spending the time and always being with Bosch India and Bosch Limited. Thank you.
Thank you, colleagues. Thank you for being with us as always.
And of course, to our colleagues here. Thank you very much.